This is what we've been building toward for a long, long time, is getting to here. Obviously, we focus on now the race-specific workouts to get them ready. Critical zone training, as V-Hill calls it. It's easy to overtrain in this period. The more prepared you are, you can kill these workouts. So you have to be controlled in how you do it. We've got a variety of races that we do at this time. This is our spring and summer, depending on the meet. Some meets are big meets. It's key distance meet. That's where you're going to run your time to get qualified for nationals or get into meets in Europe. Some are little meets. I have them run off distances, which they hate, particularly when they have to run the 8 and 15 and they're a 5K person. But some we do over distance. So maybe somebody I feel like they need strength would do an over distance race. The important point of this is that when we get into our competitive season, you want to give them workouts the athlete's good at. I believe in working on your weaknesses in the non-competitive phase. Work on what you're good at in the competitive phase. Focus on their strengths. What workouts are they good at? Ask them what workouts they like. What workouts build your confidence? That's what I say all the time. What workout do you like? Which one did you like? Pick it out. Which one were you good at? Which one builds your confidence? What have you done in college that you felt like really got you ready? That's what you want them doing. That builds their confidence, and confidence is all we need for an athlete to perform. It makes it a positive workout. And then we learn from each race. Every time you race, you can sit down. I do this different, this different. We create smart race plans. Start learning the athlete. This is what you should do. It's all the same thing that you guys do. Sometimes we have to start practicing tactics and kicking and surging because most of the guys I work with in a lot of races, they're trying to win. So they have to think about that. VO2 max ladder is very similar to what Coach V-Hill talked about. We usually do this as like a 400, 800, 1200 mile, you know, up the ladder, down the ladder, 4, 8, 12, mile, 12, 8, 4, or some variation of that, all done at 3K to 5K effort. Here's a 600 cut down. The athletes love this workout, so I give it to them quite a bit. Here's our GP4. We better hit this. If we don't, we got to redo our goals. Leg speed. This is a race week. So this is what we typically do on a race week for a 5K runner. Three sets of 3x400. These start at 5K goal pace, first set. Second set, probably 3K pace. Third set's probably close to 1500 meter pace. The recovery gets longer with each set. So first set's only 100 meter jog between the repeats. That makes sense? Second set, 200 meter jog between. Third set, 400 meter jog between. 400 between sets. Is that confusing? 1200 cut down, same thing. 1200, 1000, 8, 6, something like that. Just depends on the athlete. If I need them to do more speed or not, they seem to like that. You'll see his volume is coming down a little bit more, but he's still running more than he probably did when he was in college. So we've advanced the training a little bit. For us, this is 6 to 12 weeks. Sometimes if they go to Europe, that extends their season a little bit, but they don't really train over there. They just race all the time. So they race on Monday, and then they race Thursday, and then Sunday, and then so it's a little bit different. Reduce the volume enough that they feel fresh. We run enough that they maintain their aerobic ability, but not so much that they don't feel fresh for their workouts. We want them going into these sort of key season workouts feeling fresh. Long runs are aerobic recovery. If athletes are ever really tired, just send them on a medium long run. 90 minutes, hour 45, 2 hours. They'll recover. It's aerobic recovery. It's brilliant. It's all about confidence. We still do our drills and strides. Our ancillary circuit, which we've done through all phases, begins to reduce in volume. It becomes really dynamic. It's gone from strength in the fall and gotten more dynamic as we've crossed the year. We for each athlete, we find this sweet spot with race frequency. Some of them need to race a lot. Some of them not so much. Doesn't matter to me. It's whatever works for the athlete. Lots of coach-athlete. We meet for practice 8 times a week, so I see them all the time. But we have a lot of sit-downs by the time we get here. It's a lot of talking. What are we going to do? What tactics? Who's racing? How can I be better than I was? Most of this stuff is done at low altitude because we want to run our sea level pace. We can run sea level pace for 5K people up to about 1,200 meters in Sedona at 4,500 feet, and for 10K people up to about 2,000 meters. That's why those goal pace workouts go up to that, because I can't go farther. I can't give my 5K people mile repeats at sea level goal pace in Sedona because it's too stressful. So I'm somewhat limited by that. Final phase, recharge the body. You always have to have this phase. Recharge the energy systems, recharge the body. Go be normal. They've been exceptional. They've been abnormal for a long time. It's a great time to go on vacation, go visit their friends, maybe pay back the people who are really nice to them, their parents or people that helped them. Maybe they can go do that. For me, it's a time you pull out your notes, you look at all the workouts, you consolidate what you did. Here are the reasons I think our group has been maybe more successful quicker than we should be. As I hope I've described, we have a very patient and logical approach. Using what we've learned, what I've learned sitting in your chair, that's what this is. I bet none of this was a big surprise. It was actually, I hope, an application of what you've learned. Individualization. This is an ongoing process as I learn the athlete. We have a very open line of communication. These are young adults. I'm not so much their superior. We're equals. I have the final say, but it's all about communication and adjustment. Third is super important in our group. The team adds something intangible. I don't know what it is, but they perform better because they're part of a team. The spirit and culture that was set up by the first set of athletes, Brett Gocher, Andrew Middleton, several of those guys, was a spirit of cooperation, a spirit of celebration of the team, a spirit of excellence. They're super competitive athletes, but they really care about each other. We don't have any problems with people being selfish, per se, to the negative extent of their teammates. If you look at the pictures from Club Cross, you see the team, they're giddy about it. They love each other. It's remarkable how much the team adds. And as a result, my job is easier now. You'd think with 19 athletes, I'd be pulling my hair out. It's actually easier. We have older athletes that are mentors now of the young athletes. I just get out of the way, basically, let them do their thing. We have had the altitude advantage. There's no doubt in my mind that our athletes would have improved if our group was based at sea level. There's no doubt we would have improved. There's also no doubt that we improved more because we were at altitude. With the way we set up our training, with the focus on aerobic development, being at altitude year-round, we have some periods where we're not there, but for the most part we're there, has made the biggest difference in us, catching up. We're catching up faster because we're at altitude. Altitude's advantage goes beyond the physiological, beyond red blood cells, which I think are secondary to capillaries and enzymes, mitochondria. Suffering. If you're on an easy run, you go up a long hill at altitude, you suffer a little bit. Do that 500 times across a year, that's good for you. So I think our athletes get used to suffering. Now they also feel superior because Everybody that's good trains at altitude, so if they go to a race and somebody's not from altitude, they immediately think they're better. Whether or not, it doesn't matter. They think it. That's good. I'm biased. I chose to go to altitude. We could have set our group up anywhere, but I chose it because I think it's helpful. Maybe the results are showing it is. Attitude is huge in our group. It's a positive environment. Again, we're working with non-NCAA stars. Brett Gocher, who's become our poster boy, was second to last in the 10K. Now, he's a good runner. He shouldn't have been second to last, but he was. But the attitude is, why not me? They have nothing to lose. If Dathan Ritzenhain runs a bad race, people care. My guys run a bad race, who cares? Nobody knows them. There's no pressure. We care, of course, but mom and dad care, and people beat us up on the message boards, but we have an attitude of why not me? Why not? There's great, great examples of people who were nothing and became amazing. Why not me? I benefit a lot because we have more athletes and we have more talented athletes. First year we started our group, fastest 5K guy, 13:55. Not bad. This year, fastest 5K guy, 13:36. Different animal. He's finishing the race. This guy's got 200 to go. It makes me look like a better coach. We're getting better athletes. As you get better and better athletes, it makes it better. I started the team to try to help U.S. distance running. I came through in the 90s. We sucked in the 90s. So several people thought maybe we can help. We started it to do that. The other was that I wanted to see, could I become a coach? I could train people. I train a lot of people, back of the pack, middle of the pack. But can I become one-tenth of what Joe Vigil is? Can I become anywhere close to what Bill Aris is? Can I become that person that inspires them, that motivates them to be better than they ever thought they could be? Better than I think they can be? Can I be that person in their lives? That's what I work on. The X's and O's I feel good about because I come to conferences like this and I hear the best people in the world speak about it and I go, okay, we're doing that, we're doing that, we're doing that, check it off. The final component is the coach. And I'm not saying that because I'm a coach. We all had coaches. The coaches can make the difference. A coach that's confident in their program, believes in their athletes, and partners with them towards something greater than they already are. Young people are starving for that. Don't you think? They're starving for that. Somebody to say, I believe in you. We can do this. We're going to take them on. That's what I'm trying to do. And maybe, because I have that attitude, maybe that's helped these already exceptional people be a little better. This is my favorite quote from Arthur. If you have that, you'll look at everybody and think that person could be it. We don't know. My contact information on the right and some recommended books of people that I think are important. Thank you.